A blessed Sunday to all of you, my dear brothers and sisters. Let me start my homily by asking you a question. What is your prayer at this moment of your life? Ano kaya yung dinadasal nyo sa inyong buhay ngayon? Or when you enter the church, this shrine, this chapel, what kind of prayer you usually pray to the Lord? Kanina, pagpasok ninyo, no? What do you usually do? Or when we enter the church, what do you usually do inside the church? Do we look at the cross? Do we look at Jesus? Or do we look around people? Observe their dress? Observe those people who are entering the shrine? Sino yung mga nagsisimba? Ano yung damit nila? Kilala ko ba sila? How do we pray? What is our prayer? This Sunday, our reading, especially the Gospel, asks us, my dear brothers and sisters, to reflect ourselves. How do we pray? Paano nga ba tayo magdasal? Or ano ang una nating sinasambit sa Panginoon? In the Gospel, we can see two characters, the Pharisees and the tax collector or the publican. Two different kinds of prayer upon entering the chapel. And it's a good reflection for us this Sunday, the challenge of Jesus for us this Sunday, to look at ourselves. Are we like the Pharisees when we pray? Or are we like the tax collector when we pray? Or anong mas madalas kung tayo nagdarasal? Mas madalas ba yung kagaya ng ginagawa ng Pharisees? Or yung ginagawa ng tax collector? In the parable, when the Pharisees entered the temple and started to pray, anong ginawa niya? He make a long list or report to the Lord about his personal achievement and accomplishments, moral accomplishments. I give you thanks, O God, that I am not like the rest of men, grasping, crooked, adulterous, or even dislike this tax collector. I fast twice, I pay my tithes, that all I possess. Mentioning his own personal achievements and moral accomplishments. But looking at deeper, reflecting on the prayer of the Pharisees, it is always focused on himself. What we call self-centered prayer. Ako, I, myself. Self-centered prayer. And you try to make yourself as the basis. Di ikaw yung tama, ikaw yung panalo, ikaw yung mas magaling, ikaw yung mas mabuti. Because you focus on yourself as the basis. Mas magaling tayo sa Diyos, even mas marunong pa tayo sa Diyos, pinapangunahan natin ng Diyos. Kasi our basis is what we want. Self-centered prayer. Actually, reflecting, the Pharisee was not condemned by Jesus. Hindi niya sinabi na wag mong gawin yan. Or looking at the list mentioned by the Pharisees, all the moral acts that he does was good. Tama naman. But however, his prayer is less acceptable to God. Why? Because he trusts in his own righteousness. Hindi siya gaanong napakinggan ang kanyang dasal sapagkat nakafocus sa kanyang sarili. He trusts in his own self-righteousness. The Pharisee went to pray not to acknowledge the presence and the grace of God. But what he did was to recognize himself as the highest in the pedestal and comparing himself to others. The Pharisee went to the temple not to report on what God has does in his life or how God works in his life or how he experienced the mercy and forgiveness of God. But the Pharisee in his prayer was too self-righteous about himself. He was so boastful before God Lord, ito yung nagawa ko. Lord, ito yung aking nakamit. Lord, ito yung aking ginagawa. He always focuses on himself. That's why if you are too righteous, it makes us better than God. If you are too self-righteous, we uplift ourselves even to the point na inaapakan natin yung ibang tao. The Pharisee went to pray not to recognize the presence of God. The Pharisee went to pray not to list how he experienced the mercy, the presence of God in his life, but he was too focused on himself. The Pharisee failed that everything that he has, that everything that he has comes not only from his effort, but from God. Nakalimutan niya na ang lahat ng kanyang biyaya, lahat ng kanyang accomplishment, hindi niya magagawa yon kung wala ang grasya, ang biyaya at ang patnubay ng Diyos. Kaya hindi mas nadinig ang kanyang dasal. On the contrary, here a tax collector, hindi siya lumapit sa harapan. Bagkos nahiya siya, nasa likod. He cannot look up to God in prayer. He bowed down and strike his breast and say, a very short prayer, yet a very meaningful prayer. Ano yung dasal niya? O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. Lord, patawarin mo ko or kaawaan mo ko sapagkat ako'y nagkasala. A very beautiful and short prayer. O God, be merciful to me, a sinner. In this short prayer, the tax collector, the publican, acknowledge the need for God in his life. It is a prayer of humility. It's a prayer of self-centered, para lang sa sarili. Pero itong tax collector, ang dasal niya, dasal ng pagpapakumbaba. Recognizing that is in his unworthiness before God, his need for God's forgiveness and mercy. In his prayer of humility, he recognizes brokenness. He recognizes unworthiness. That's why he needs God's healing. He recognized that he is not perfect. That's why he needs the guidance of God. Isang panalangin na pag-ako na kailangan natin ng Diyos sa ating buhay. That a prayer that says, without God, we are nothing. We need God's generosity in our life. A very short prayer, yet a very meaningful prayer that reminds us that we need God in our life. In our unworthiness, in our sinfulness, in our brokenness, we ask for God's grace to be part of our life. O God, be merciful to me. I am a sinner. That's why in the second reading, St. Paul reminds us to persevere, that in our weakness and trials, God stood by our side and gave us the strength to continue on in our life. To never give up, but to finish the race. Kaya nga kung titignan mo, my dear brothers and sisters, comparing the two, the Pharisee in his prayer, it's a self-centered prayer, centering on oneself. While the tax collector, it is centered on God. Yung Pharisee, he praises himself, his accomplishments, but the other, he praises God. Hindi niya pinuri yung kanyang sarili, bagkos pinuri niya ang Diyos, ang kabutihan ng Diyos sa kanyang buhay. The other asks for everything. Ang dami niyang dinadasal sa Panginoon. But yung isa, wala siyang hiningi. Bagkos nagpapakumbaba siya sa Diyos, humihingi lang siya ng kanyang habag at awa. Sisters and brothers, this parable is like a mirror to us. When Jesus shared this parable in our gospel today, hinaharap niya ang sangsalamin sa atin upang tignan natin ang ating sarili. Are we like the tax collector when we pray? Or are we like the Pharisee when we pray? It is not selecting anong mas mabuti. It is not selecting which is wrong or right. But it is a moment for us to look at ourselves to reflect within us, to mirror in ourselves, ano nga ba ang kadalasan nating ginagawa kung tayo nagdarasal sa Panginoon? Isa bang dasal na papuri, hindi sa Diyos, kundi sa ating sarili? Yung sinasabi natin, papuri sa Diyos, sa kaitaasan. But sometimes we say, papuri sa akin, kasi ako ay nasa kaitaasan. Or not glory to God in the highest, but glory to me because I am the highest. Yan ang dasal ng Pharisee. Self-centered prayer, too much righteousness. Or are we like the tax collector when we look at the mirror and look at ourselves when we pray in humility, with a contrite heart, recognizing the need for God, that we are like children, praying in front of our Father, trusting and putting our providence, trusting and putting ourselves in His providence, on the goodness of God in our life. Pero kung titignan natin, ano mas pinapakinggan na Diyos na dasal? It is not the prayer of the Pharisee, but it's the prayer of the tax collector. Because Jesus says, whoever humbles himself will be, whoever exalts himself will be humbled, and the one who humbles himself will be exalted. The first reading in the book of Sirach reminds us that what God hears, yung mga dasal, ay God always hear the cry of the oppressed. Those who serve God willingly is heard, whose petition reaches to heaven. Mas favorable ang Diyos kung tayo marunong magpakumbaba, when we put God at the center of our life, when we recognize the presence of God in our life. And also, in our humble prayer, isang magandang dasal para sa ating, bago ka humiling, bago ka mag-list down ng iyong mga petitions sa Panginoon, isang magandang dasal para sa akin na sana lagi natin ginagawa kung tayo papasok sa simbahan or tayo may personal prayer, aside from a humble prayer, a contrite prayer, is a thanksgiving prayer. Marunong tayong magpasalamat sa biyaya ng Panginoon. In prayer, we're grateful to God's blessings in our life. God is so generous to us. God is so good to us despite our failures. God is always pouring His blessings to us even in our unworthiness. Sana sa dasal natin, marunong din tayong magpasalamat. Kaya nga sabi, if we know how to thank God, then we always thank God. To thank God is to thank God. Kung nagpapasalamat ka sa iyong dasal, iniisip mo ang Diyos. Dahil pag iniisip mo ang Diyos, lahat ng biyayang iyong natatanggap ay nagmula sa Panginoon. Thanksgiving prayer. And another prayer that I want you to put in mind also, my dear brothers and sisters, when we humble ourselves before God, is also to pray for other people. Huwag lang tayong magdasal para sa ating sarili. Self-centered prayer, like the Pharisee. But we also pray for other people. Be instrument of God to other people. Pagdasal nyo ang ibang tao. Ipagdasal natin ang mga kailangan ng ating mga kapwa-tao. That's a very good Christian act, that we pray also for other people's needs more than what we need or what is beneficial to us. This Sunday, we're praying for special intention, and that is we are praying for all missionaries who are working all over the world to share the good news. Today is the World Mission Sunday. Ipagdasal natin ang mga misyonero. Kami mga SVD, the Society of the Divine Word, running this seminary, Christ the King Mission Seminary, and this Shrine of Jesus the Divine Word, are considered a missionary congregation. We are more than 6,000 members working all over more than 60 countries sharing the good news of Jesus. Please pray for us that we may be faithful like St. Paul in doing our mission to share the good news of God. Pray also to all of us here gathered, all Christians, that maantig yung puso natin, maisip natin na hindi lang kami, mga pari, brothers, sisters, are missionaries. But like the call of Pope Francis, we are all missionaries. We are all witnesses of Jesus. Sana, we are being reminded also today that we share the good news of Jesus in our everyday life. We are all missionaries. To end, I remember one scene in a movie, Tanging Yaman. In that movie, merong isang bata kasama ng kanyang lola. So yung lola kasama yung kanyang apo, pumunta sila sa simbahan para magdasal. So when they entered the church, they kneel down and pray. And in his curiosity, yung apo, tinitignan niya yung loob ng simbahan, paligid. And he saw many people kneeling down, praying. At ang innocent question niya sa kanyang lola, "Lola, naririnig ba ng Diyos ang lahat ng ating dasal? Napakaraming nagdadasal. Naririnig ba ng Diyos ang lahat ng ating dasal?" My dear brothers and sisters, ano ang dasal mo ngayon? Pinapakinggan kaya ng Diyos ang iyong dasal? At bakit pinapakinggan ng iyong dasal? Is it because it's a self-centered prayer? Or it's because a prayer of humility, a prayer of thanksgiving, and a prayer that also involves other people? Pinapakinggan kaya ng Diyos ang ating dasal? Amen.